The fifth video in this series leads the Bank of England along Poultry, twisting and turning on its way to Leicester Square. There's a link to a map of the route below. Pass by Mansion House along Poultry into Cheapside towards St Mary Le Bow Church. It's said that those born within earshot of the sound of its bells can claim to be true Cockneys. 40 metres before the church, turn right along King Street towards the Guildhall, administrative and ceremonial centre of the City of London, which also houses a decent art gallery and the remains of a Roman amphitheatre. The weather vane on the spire of nearby St Lawrence Jury Church is in the form of a gridiron on account of poor Lawrence being barbecued to death. Leave along Gresham Street, then turn into Wood Street towards the Barbican, passing London's own Leaning Tower, all that remains of St Albans Church after Second World War bombing. Turn left to find remnants of London's ancient wall on both sides of the road, before taking the elevated walkway to St Giles Cripplegate Church in one direction, and the widely praised Museum of London in the other. From the museum, head south before slipping through peaceful Postman's Park, then along King Edward Street towards the rear of London Stock Exchange, before turning by Christchurch Greyfriars Church, yet another victim of Second World War bombs. Just past the Central Criminal Court, better known as the Old Bailey, which like the Royal Courts of Justice can be visited subject to stringent security measures, take the road between St Sepulchre's Church and the supposedly haunted Viaduct Pub towards St Bartholomew's Hospital, the oldest in Britain. Opposite, the Golden Boy of Pie Corner is located where the Great Fire of London eventually burned itself out. Further along, a statue of King Henry VIII stands above an entrance to the hospital, and further still, there's a memorial to William Wallace, who was executed nearby as long ago as 1305. The path below the nearby Byng Tudor building leads to St Bartholomew the Great Church, one of London's oldest. Beyond Smithfield Meat Market, extremely active in the early hours when most are sleeping, but resembling a morgue at other times, follow Charterhouse Street before turning left into Farringdon Road and climbing the steps onto Holborn Viaduct, past the City Temple and St Andrew's Church, before cutting right to Ely Place, the last privately owned street in London and home to St Etheldreda's Church, which dates from the reign of King Edward I. Close to the entrance of Ely Place, take the narrow passage to Ye Old Mitre Pub, a favourite with tourists and associated with Queen Elizabeth I. Continue along the passage to Hatton Garden, famous for jewellery, which is frequently visited by the romantically involved and wishful thinkers. Returning to Holborn, past the equestrian statue of Prince Albert, consort of Queen Victoria, then the red brick Prudential building, before crossing towards the timber-framed facade of Staple Inn. Walk through the courtyard if it's open, or via Chancery Lane if it isn't, to the Silver Vaults, a subterranean parade of retail outlets predominantly selling silver and worth a visit. Security is understandably tight but largely unobtrusive, with most people being permitted entry. Along Chancery Lane, Eden Ravenscroft, the oldest tailor's in London, is the preferred outfitter to many of the judiciary and robe maker for the royal family. Just before the neo-Gothic King's College building, turn into Carey Street towards the rear of the Royal Courts of Justice. Pass a couple of ancient parish boundary stones and the 17th century Seven Stars public house, before turning into Searle Street, where a statue of Thomas More occupies a niche on the corner. The precincts of Lincoln's Inn to the right can be visited most weekdays, and a variety of guided tours are available. Lincoln's Inn Fields to the left, now a pleasant square, was once a place of execution. To the south, the macabre Hunterian Museum attracts its fair share of inquisitive visitors, while to the north, Sir John Soane's Museum is especially popular on the occasional evenings when illuminated by candlelight. Before leaving via Sardinia Street, stroll a few metres along nearby Portsmouth Street, where the old curiosity shop is surrounded by the more modern buildings of the London School of Economics. At the end of busy Kingsway, bear right past Bush House, former home of the BBC's World Service, then just before the Waldorf Hilton Hotel, enter Drury Lane. opposite Sarastro, the flamboyant theatre-themed restaurant, head alongside the Theatre Royal towards Covent Garden, a mecca for tourists and Londoners alike, where with St Paul's Church as a backdrop, popular entertainers entertain throughout the day. Finally, leave via King Street and then New Row towards Leicester Square and the nearby restaurants of Chinatown. The next stage of this walking tour of London leaves Leicester Square along Piccadilly before passing through St James's and Westminster to the River Thames at Lambeth Bridge. To watch the video, click the link.